He was out on his deck with his wife when a strange object in the distance caught his eye.
I was looking at this thing drop through the clouds, and it's a glowing ball of what appears to be fire. It's kind of a golden yellow color, very bright, and it's coming straight at us.
Terry stood and watched, transfixed. Neither of them had ever seen anything like it, but there was more to come.
Shortly after the first one went by, another one dropped out of the sky, following the exact same route, exact same pattern, takes the same turn, flying at about 1,500 feet after dropping some altitude. I was watching the second one with binoculars and got a much better view of it than I could with the naked eye. It looked to me like it was a cauldron of molten metal. You got this churning effect going on. And then I noticed there were these rotating lights that were chasing each other around the rim of this disk. And then it disappeared out of my view. We were just dumbfounded.
And one particularly bizarre aspect was that there was no noise. Whatever they were, these flying objects were totally silent.
Not hearing any sound, that was really bizarre. And that's what really blew my mind.
Terry is far from alone. Southeast Alaska is renowned for its UFO sightings. This strange light performing unusual maneuvers was seen off the coast in October 2020. This video of the object was taken in Skagway at the top of the Alaska Panhandle. These curious photos were taken from an outlying island 2 months earlier. And this, off the coast of Juneau in 2011. But the most spectacular sightings come from Ketchikan. Just one example is this video, which was taken on New Year's Eve 2012. Local residents were on the mountainside making preparations for a spectacular fireworks display. There are unexplained strange lights in the sky moving above the mountain. These lights still haven't been explained. They can only be described as unidentified flying objects. Of all the extraordinary reports to have come out of Alaska, the most bizarre must be that somewhere in the wilderness there's a giant pyramid of unknown origin, the existence of which is known only to a few select people. The journey begins in Dayton, Ohio, over 2,000 miles from Alaska. It's a center of the defense and aeronautical industries. It's also home to former Army Chief Warrant Officer Doug Mutchler. For 15 years, Doug worked in U.S. counterintelligence.
Counterintelligence agent, investigated espionage terrorism against the United States.
In 1989, Doug was posted to Fort Richardson on the outskirts of Anchorage, Alaska. He had no idea then of the bizarre journey he was about to embark upon.
When I arrived in Alaska in 89, in September, first thing you do is orientate yourself to your AO, area of operation. So I went and got some maps. So while I was putting the maps up, there was this one area. It was whited out. This area not surveyed to date. And I'm looking at the whole of Alaska. I mean, that's a big place, and it's all been surveyed, except this one area. With my counterintelligence background, I was like, they're hiding something. It's not my business. And I let it go.
Doug was used to working on a need-to-know basis. But a few years later, an extraordinary event magnified his suspicions.
Move forward to 1992, I was sitting there watching TV in the orderly room, and there's a news program on. And they're talking about the detonation of a nuclear device in China. Part of the story was that geologists used that detonation to get a better picture of the crust and mantle of the Earth.
The news report stated that the explosion was so great that it sent shockwaves underground through the fabric of the Earth. These shockwaves traveled over 4,000 miles all the way to Alaska, where they were picked up by earthquake monitoring stations. By analyzing these waves, scientists could tell the density of the rock they passed through. And they detected what appeared to be an enormous subterranean structure shaped like a perfect pyramid.
They said in Alaska, a pyramid was found larger than the one in Giza.
The Great Pyramid of Giza in Egypt is over 450 feet high. It's one of the most awe-inspiring feats of human engineering. And here was a news report stating that there was a pyramid bigger than this in Alaska, underground.
We got a pyramid larger than the one in Giza. They showed it on the map. And the whited out area I saw earlier in 89, they correlated. Same area, which I thought was, oh my God, that's what they're hiding.
Andrew Goff is a writer and historian who's been looking into Doug's claims.
This is interesting. On May 22, 1992, the Chinese did detonate a massive underground nuclear bomb. It was the largest test they'd ever done, about 70 times bigger than Hiroshima. The US and the Soviets had signed a treaty limiting the size of these tests, but the Chinese weren't part of that deal. Whether an underground pyramid was detected by analyzing seismic waves, well, there's no independent proof of that. There's no record of it. But Doug Mutchler, a former counterintelligence figure, well-respected guy, why would he invent such a story?
In 2020, late one November evening, an extraordinary video was taken. It was shot by a local man traveling along the main highway of the small town of Wasilla. Wes Smith was on his way to the convenience store with his wife when something in the sky caught their eye.
We saw two pairs of lights. Each of them were in triangular formation with three lights apiece on the points.
The lights were low to the road, but still the couple presumed they were planes. But the closer they got, the less sure they were.
You've seen planes and they'll bank, you know, and my mom was a pilot for 20 years. This thing came to a dead standstill, and without changing orientation or moving, it just started left. There was no banking. I mean, it was just boom, boom. Just kept moving. It was very strange.
Odder still was the fact that these low-flying craft were totally silent. Even drones make some noise.
It's like everything you've ever been taught is kind of going out the window, because how is that possible? How is it not making noise? How did it just move sideways? It was pretty stunning. It was spectacular. I've never seen anything like it.
But perhaps the most striking video from 2020 comes from Palmer, just 11 miles from Wasilla. Lifelong resident Michael Dillon was filming the beautiful Alaskan night sky when a strange light suddenly appeared.
All of a sudden, there it was, and it just appeared, like right there in the center of the frame. And I saw it with my naked eye as well. It was moving from west to east and then just shot straight up.
This video has never been shown on TV before.
At first I was thinking, no, there's no way. There's no way. And I rolled the camera back and I watched it, and there it was, right there.
The light of an aircraft wouldn't suddenly appear in the middle of the frame. And the subsequent movement is very unusual.
So it was very obvious to me at that point that we were not witnessing a natural phenomenon. For something to change direction that fast, at that far away, and at that speed, a human body would be liquefied. I mean, there's no way it would be able to withstand the G-forces of that. I honestly don't know what it was, but I want to find out.